you be the guy who like, let's do that TikTok.
Which one?
So you both will be,
yes, that one.
What's up guys, my name is Nikhil and you're watching Menu Please, the show where we go around the city and try the best Indian food. In today's episode of Menu Please, we're having Jalebi, one traditional and authentic and one gourmet and unconventional. See which one we prefer. But will we prefer any? Because we're having Jalebi. Why are we doing this? I thought we had a discussion that I don't like, but I digress. I know I'm having my least favorite Indian sweet, but at least I'm having it with my most favorite Indian comics, Supriya Joshi and Niveditha Prakasam. You've seen Supriya on Comicstan, you've seen Niveditha on Queens of Comedy, and soon you'll see them both with their own special on Netflix. Guys, I'm actually in the car with two queens of comedy. You guys have got what a lot of comedians aspire to have, a Netflix special, but obviously it's been a long journey. What was your first open mic like?
So I actually started doing stand-up in 2017, and I didn't want to do it because I didn't think I would be good at it. This place called Summer House Cafe in Bombay, it was packed to capacity and it's a big place. And I was like, I can't do this. All I'm doing throughout this is just pacing like this, like a tiger on the stage. And I'm not even looking at the audience, I'm just like this. And when I said the first joke and people laughed, like, laughed, like, that was like the biggest epiphany.
Did you like actually stop on stage?
I stopped, I did. And I was like, Oh my god, I'm actually funny.
After listening to that, what was your first experience like?
I did my first open mic in 2014. And then my second open mic was in 2016. So it took me two years to get to my second.
Meticulously writing for the second open mic.
I didn't know how comedy worked at the time because there were no open mics in Chennai. A group called the BBC in Chennai, and they hosted a big mic. I thought that was a legitimate open mic until like later we found out that BBC wasn't even a comedy group.
The first restaurant we're visiting today is Punjab Sweet House. I've been here before, I've had Pani Puri, I've had a bunch of chaats over here and I really enjoy it, but I found out now that they're famous for jalebi. I've not had good jalebi experience in my life, and I think lately I can't stand things that are too sweet.
Why?
You guys look very upset with
me. Yeah, I was just wondering what a bad jalebi experience means.
Yeah.
Like, did something happen? Was there an insect?
Okay, someone hugged you while you were eating.
And then you ate half.
Every time
jalebi.
I eat a jalebi, I just, some stranger punches me in the face.
Man,
I don't get it.
To balance the sweet of jalebi, you eat with rabdi, which is not as sweet. That combo, and it's hot and cold. Oh.
You know that, I've never had a jalebi with rabdi.
So
let's see.
Feel like today your life is changing.
Here at Punjab Sweet House, this is the jalebi stall. As you guys can see over here, they're serving hot jalebis. This part I really enjoy.
Yes.
Watching them make it, it smells really good.
Yeah.
It's a smell that reminds me of my bachpan, yaar. We'd gone on a family vacation to Jaipur. And at that time, it was like really cold and all of us were like, ugh. My parents, they got us hot milk, dipped two jalebis inside of it. So you end up drinking the hot milk and it's sweetened with the jalebi chashni. And at the end of the glass, there's still two jalebis waiting for you.
In North India, this is an actual breakfast.
Yeah.
They have jalebis with hot milk.
Wow.
Actually, South Indians have their own sort of variation of the jalebi and it's thicker.
It's called jangri. And it's it's much smaller, but it has pretty much the same taste.
Yeah. It's less this jalebi and more like...
It's not big and thin, it's thick
like,
and fat.
Okay, enough talking. Can we just eat this?
Yes, I'm ready.
You guys can have from mine if you want extra.
No, we don't
rabdi.
Want your extra rabdi jalebi.
Why do you not want extra? Rabdi is the best thing.
Jalebi gang, cheers.
Holy shit.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Oh, yum.
That is so good.
I put an entire jalebi in my mouth. Now it's gone.
I honestly had an out-of-body experience. I'm not joking.
My thoughts on the jalebi. I really love it because it's hot. But
it's
imagining eating this later. How do you guys find it if like you ate it later? Like, it was
you know what, Kinney? You need to live in the moment. You're eating crispy hot jalebis now. Savor it.
I've kind of zoned out and gone to jalebi world.
Okay, we have been given poha.
Poha?
In Madhya Pradesh, it's very common as a breakfast to eat poha and jalebi.
Okay, let's do it, man. Wow!
Oh my god!
This is the best thing! Why what have I not been eating this all my life?
Holy shit!
Jalebi and poha is the best breakfast.
I agree.
Should we try doing this?
We should.
It looks easy, but eventually. I feel like there's more to it.
Oh, does it look easy to you, Kitty? Yeah.
So, hum bhi try kar sakte?
You.
I think you should go first.
You go?
I'm actually scared of hot oil. Oh god. Yo, she went for it.
Look at the last one. Once I got practice,
the last one looks like a murku. Alright, who's gonna go next?
You.
Wow.
Alright, oh my god. I feel like I'm making jalebi Cheetos.
What? Your
I'm changing the game.
Let me show you.
What if you suck at this?
I won't.
Okay, your circular motion is actually very good.
I killed it, man.
Same.
Dude, listen, I was the best.
Come on.
Oh my god, just look at mine.
Just look at
mine. I'm so sorry.
You can't cheat like that on camera.
What are you talking about? Oof. Alright, we've had an amazing first meal. Are you guys ready to go to the next restaurant?
Yes!
Try gourmet jalebi, whatever that is.
We have to eat.
As long as it has rabdi, I'm gonna be happy. Yeah. Let's go. Alright guys, we finished restaurant one. What was your experience in one word?
Magnificent.
New.
You had a childhood story from jalebi. I wanted to know what you guys were like as children.
I moved to a girls' school for high school. I loved my girls' school experience because there were just some crazy, crazy people there.
And then you went to study automobile engineering, which seems like a complete departure from all girls' school.
Yeah. I don't do this on purpose, but I always end up putting myself in very uncomfortable situations.
I feel like all of these bad decisions have led to good material.
Yeah. I think that's what's led me.
Comedic voice, probably.
Yeah.
You filmed your special on Netflix. What does that feel like?
It takes a lot of work. Even when we're just building material for a special or even just for like 5 minutes also, it takes months and months and months of just
sometimes years.
Of course, we were continuously writing, performing. Till the D-Day, and that is the day when I got really worried that my voice shouldn't go. This is what happens when I feel extremely under pressure, I lose my voice.
Oh no!
Yeah.
You're the stand-up comedian.
This is what I have to do.
Oh no.
I can't not go on stage.
The one thing you need. Have there been days where you've lost your voice, you've just gone on stage, like mimed or some shit?
The finale of Comicstan, I lost my voice. So now just do whatever the f*** you want to do, because clearly no one's going to be able to hear you anyway, so it doesn't matter.
That's a very big part of comedy where you have to say your truth, because everybody that's watching, at least for me, when I watch stand-up, I watch it to see what other people feel about what I'm feeling, like their opinion of it, and if they feel the same way, it makes you feel better. Stand-up is the only art form and only place you're allowed to say whatever you want because you're not serious about it. It's a joke.
Or you are.
You are serious about it, but you're not preaching it.
Yeah.
You're not saying this is set in stone.
Yeah.
You're just saying this is my theory. Yeah.
Alright, so we're nearing restaurant number two.
Woo!
Oh
we're going
gosh.
To Masala House
Library. Come on!
You guys are going to host this instead.
Yes! Yeah. Guys, hi! So we are now on our way to the next location where we will eat some gourmet jalebi.
That's right.
The name of the place is Masala
Library!
Who asked you?
Biblioteca. Oh, sorry.
Masala Library.
Masala Library.
Nice.
They're known for performing molecular gastronomy on traditional Indian recipes. Shall we get the food in?
That's what we're here for.
What?
Oh, they're bubbles. They're bubbles
on
it.
Oh my god.
So this is one of our famous dish. Our signature is called jalebi kavya. So that's the jalebi on the side. That's the rabdi with some pistachio saffron milk foam on the side.
Oh my god.
The gastronomy has come to life. I thought that was actual like
I thought that was going to be,
That's a jalebi. It's in a caviar.
I forgot we were eating jalebi also.
Oh my god.
Enjoy it.
I'm going to have the foam first.
I'm going to take everything that's there with the flour.
Oh my god.
I'm so confused.
The bite is so good. There are so many things happening in my mouth. They've gone a step further.
Is it multiplying in your mouth?
Give me a moment to process.
No, it's too complicated. I don't think I have the intellectual capacity to describe this dish.
When they kept this plate here, I thought he meant actual caviar.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Would you guys have been scared to eat this if it was so exotic?
I would have been super excited.
I would be really excited because you don't eat this every day. No.
Actually, yeah.
You don't eat molecular roti sabji.
I want to ask you guys one last thing about the food. You remember how we took that first bite of traditional jalebi and rabdi?
Yeah.
And it was like an explosion of flavor.
Mm.
If we forget the molecular aspects of this, are you still getting that vibe?
You know, that is the taste of familiarity.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the taste of comfort.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is a taste of something new. Like, it is still jalebi rabdi, but it isn't like zhush. This is like...
That was more like...
Yeah.
And this is like...
It's two completely unique experiences.
Yeah, same thing, but it's triggering different responses.
Well, I'm very excited to see both of your specials.
My specials about my life, what I experienced in life so far. It speak about a bad breakup and how I got over it. And also self-love, self-care and self-preservation and selfies.
And yours?
So the things that I say are things that I've always thought about since I was like 15 years old. Because I talk about growing up in different places, like from Nairobi to Coimbatore, and how it changed from such a urban liberal environment to an extremely conservative environment. And I'm just a very confused person, and I talk about that. And I also talk about colorism. Which is something that's very absurd because I come from the south where we're like predominantly dark skin and for some reason still have a problem with it. Like because in Tamil Nadu there's a saying, Karpa Andalum Kalayarka, which is although she's dark skinned, she's beautiful.
Guys, stay tuned. Watch the specials on Netflix coming very soon. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to leave a like, share it with your friends, comment what you think we should have in the next episode. Signing off with Jalebi. Jalebi awesome, everybody. I actually really love rabdi and malpua. Malpua sweet is like
I love
deathbed, okay?
I can't eat kheer because I'm lactose intolerant.
Oh no. But rabdi also is
Yeah, rabdi is also.
That's why I can't have that also.
Oh.
I can.
I don't know what's happening here.
Why are you telling us these important things in stages?
Also, I am diabetic. So I cannot.
Wait, should we just have pani puri? Should we just change it up?